Emily, and this is Emily Catherine Illustration YouTube channel, and welcome. So I'm an artist and I'm an illustrator, and I use a lot of popular culture aspects in my work, and I use a lot of musical influences because I love hip hop. So this channel was brought about because people were asking me about my process, and I was posting videos up and they were commenting like, how do you do that? So I thought I'd make a whole channel for you guys so I can show you. But I'm a big supporter of independent business, and so I thought it might be really nice to showcase some of the musicians' work that's sending me in tracks for me to paint to, as well as obviously promoting some new art styles. So as it goes along, I'll get a commission in and I'll just show you how I'm doing it. I'll do a time lapse with some really cool music playing, and then I'll explain a little bit of some of the techniques that I use over all sorts of different ways that I produce illustrations. And the first one is really special to launch the channel, and that is the Bras Not Bombs charity canvas that I'm doing. So Bras Not Bombs is a grassroots charity, and they raise money for refugee women and children who might not have everything that they need. So we raise money for bras and pants and sanitary items and all sorts of other things. And it's really special because it's grassroots and brought from the very beginning. So everyone is going to have a huge celebration for International Women's Day to raise as much money as possible. And I was asked to do a canvas. So I put a vote out on social media and I said, who would you like? Who is an inspirational woman? And you guys picked Maya Angelou. So today I'm going to be beginning to paint the Maya Angelou painting with some amazing music over the top. And I'm going to break and show you what I'm doing. And then we're going to auction the canvas off on eBay so that you can bid for it and raise money for a really good cause. So yeah, welcome. Thank you for watching. So we're going to start with the background first, and luckily I have already chosen the colour for that. So I've just got to let that dry now, and then I'll be working on the face and the headscarf. So I've just made that grey. I do all of my faces in like grayscale, so different shades of grey. It's quite a common pop art technique. It just means that you can put quite flat, blocky colours on other parts of the person's sort of canvas and stuff, because then you're not detracting away from the details of the face. So that's how I like to do it at the moment. It's quite like not a signature style, but I do it a lot. I find that it's quite effective because I like to use spray paint as well. So that's the grey that we've got. And I'll use the same part throughout the painting and add a bit more black or a bit more white throughout. And then you'll see I'll start adding the white in at the end. So, yeah. Right, so I've completed all of the outlines and we're ready for the next section. Okay, so now I'm going to put a wash over all of the lines. And that just, it reminds me which is shadow and which is some of the black bits that go on. And the reason why I do that is I just don't have the memory. It's such a big piece that if I just traced and followed it with my eye, I wouldn't be able to figure it out. So I put a wash on, and then that will tell me which bits to do. It will differentiate between. And then I'll take you to the next stage. So next, I'm going to add a darker grey to this grey because we're going to do the shading around the face. So lots of different layers of greys to create a three-dimensional effect. So that's next. Okay, so now I'm going to add some black and I'm going to do this in a separate pot because what I don't want to do is add black to this grey because I'm going to need it for later. So yeah. I was just thinking that the canvas stinks and it's because before I started this, I wanted to double gesso it. Gesso is a thing that you use to help prepare the canvas for paint. And when you do it, you normally just do one coat. But because I knew it was going to be filmed, I did two coats, but it stinks. And so now I'm up quite close to the canvas, and yeah, it smells a farmyard. So what I'm doing is, even though it's making it look worse, I'm finding every bit of paint that hasn't been properly soaked into the canvas. I'm going over with a slightly darker tone of grey, so that when I put the light and the dark bits back on, it'll come up. okay, so we finished the face and I'm fairly happy with it. So now I'm just going to put some colour on the rest of the canvas. I like to use really neon bright colours, which is why I grayscale all my faces. And for that, I use spray paint and lots of other stuff. For this, I'm going to use spray paint. I'm going to be using Montana 94. Montana, really flat, non-drippy colour, really reliable spray paint, and I get it all from Montana Shop Nottingham, which is the UK's sole supplier of Montana paints. So yeah, highly recommend it, and all the neon colours really good. So yeah, we're just going to put some colour on. Okay, so I've already just done the earrings, but what I'm going to be doing is doing the gold drips now on her top. And for that I use this solvent ink called Mr. Gold, and I have to decant it into a glass tumbler, and it's oil based, so I have to use white spirits, and I'm just going to go along the whole of the top dripping. I'm actually going to put a secret Maya Angelou quote inside her top. So I'll be manipulating the drips to turn into very, very long letters. So from a distance, it should just look like a patterned top. But when you get up close, you'll be able to read a good message through it. So that's what we're going to do now. Okay, so I've finally finished, and the gold drips are actually a Maya Angelou quote. And the quote reads, "Each time a woman stands up for herself, without knowing it possibly, without claiming it, she stands up for all women." I think because we're doing this as a charity event for Bras Not Bombs to raise money for women refugees, I think it's perfect, and it's good for any Maya Angelou fans out there. So yeah, this is done. So if you've enjoyed what you've seen today and you've enjoyed what you've listened to, please click on the link. Citizen Griot made the track, or Griot, I can't remember how to pronounce it. All of his links are in the metadata. Please click subscribe to my YouTube channel. My website is emilycatherineillustration.com. I'm Emily Catherine Illustration on Facebook, same on Instagram, and on Twitter I'm IllustrationEC. For any information at all, please contact me. I'm happy to answer any questions at all. And more to come will be not just large canvases, but some small watercolours and loads more brand new music, so tune in.